Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll look at charting in Excel. Specifically, how to choose the appropriate chart type for your data, how to calculate standard error and confidence intervals, and customizing individual chart features such as axes, error bars, and trend lines. Excel can generate many types of charts. Let's take a look at a few of them. Pie charts are well suited for illustrating portions of a whole. For example, how a fixed amount of resources is distributed, or, as we see here, the percentage of US mobile phone subscribers that belong to each of the largest manufacturers of smartphones. Bar charts are good for comparing quantitative data from two or more categories. Here, we see the results of an experiment comparing growing conditions for plants. The first category represents the control group. It did not receive any additional treatment. The second group received treatment 1, and the third group received treatment 2. Typically, each group will have numerous samples, plants in this case, and the value shown is the group's average. Let's create a chart from this data. First, we select our data that we want to chart. Under the Insert tab of the ribbon, we select a bar chart. This gives us a basic chart. Let's customize the categories. We do this by right-clicking the chart and selecting Select Data, or by clicking the Filter button on the chart. Here, we can specify the names for our categories. If we had more data series, that is, more data for each category, we could define them here. We can also change the chart style, colors, and layout if we want to. Again, this can be done via the ribbon or the buttons on the chart. I suggest that you select options that are closest to what you want, and then make changes from there. Alternatively, you can modify each component of the chart individually. For each component of the chart, you can specify the line and fill color, special visual effects, and size and alignment properties, if applicable. For the axes, there are options for minimum and maximum values, gradation levels, and number format. If you find yourself performing the same chart customizations repeatedly, you might want to consider saving your changes to a template. Sometimes, you might see vertical lines at the top of each bar. These extra lines are called error bars. They can be used to illustrate the variability of the data using the standard deviation, standard error, or confidence intervals. Let's add error bars to this chart. First, we will need to calculate the values that the error bars will represent. Here's the standard deviation. Standard error is equal to the standard deviation divided by the square root of the number of samples. And the confidence interval, representing 95% of our data, is the standard error multiplied by 1.96, though this is often rounded to 2. Here are some options for the error bars. I recommend always calculating the error bar values yourself and specifying them here. If we wanted to, we could also move the chart to its own sheet in the workbook. A line chart quantifies changes over time. It contains one or more sequences of data points, with the data points joined in order by straight lines. Let's look at this data from Professor Clark from York's biology department. It represents the orange, red, and yellow beetle populations over 10 generations. Again, we select our data, and we make changes to the chart's appearance as needed. let's change the color of each line to reflect the name of the beetle. Here, we have separate options for the dataset's line and marker. The last chart type that we'll be covering is the scatter plot. This data is from Professor Davis in York's kinesiology department. It lists the height and weight of a selection of students. Like a line chart, a scatter plot contains one or more sequences of data points, but these points are not joined. Instead, a line of best fit, or trend line, is typically added to visualize a correlation between the variables on the x and y axes. If you know the type of relationship between your variables, you can specify it here. Otherwise, choosing a linear relationship is often a good starting point. We can display the equation of the trend line, and also the r-squared value to determine how well the trend line fits our data. A value close to 1 is desirable, so this line fits very well. Although we've covered a lot of chart options, there are still many more. I encourage you to experiment with them yourself. Thanks for watching.